Good morning, everybody, and thank you for tuning back into Altros Barbecue. So today we've got ourselves a corned brisket. We're going to be smoking this low and slow to start with, then we're going to crank it up, and we're going to enjoy a beautiful Sunday roast dinner. It's been a bit cold recently, so let's get cooking. Here's what we've got to cook with today. Lovely corned brisket. As you can see, pretty cheap, $8 a kilo, which is very, very cheap. Looking forward to cooking this one today. The difference between brisket and corned brisket is basically the curing process. So what you're doing with the corned brisket is you're curing it in a salt solution. That's to try and maximize the flavor, to try and tenderize the lean piece of meat as much as you can. The first thing that we're doing is just trimming away at the fat and the silver skin on the backside of the brisket. Now I'm only cooking at home here, so you can trim away as much as you want. I'm going to leave a little bit of fat on the back side, and then on the side and the top, I'm just going to trim it down so it's about a quarter of an inch. Because this has been cured for quite some time, the meat is going to be quite salty. So what I'm going to do for a couple of hours is just put the corned brisket into some water. That's to try and draw out some of that saltiness. Because if you don't do this, it can be super, super salty. You can go as long as you want. If you want to go overnight, go overnight, but a minimum of 2 hours. At that point, get your corned brisket out, pat it dry. You probably don't need to use any yellow mustard or oil here for a binder because it is quite wet already, but I decided to put some on just to give it a little bit of a coating and to help the rub stick to the meat. Today, what I'm going to be using is a Sunday roast. There is a little bit of salt in here, but I do recommend using a rub which is not too salt-based because you've already got plenty of salt flavor in that meat from the curing process for the corned brisket. Make sure you give both sides a good cover. With this particular rub, I've been wanting to try it for quite some time. I've got most of the ingredients in my cupboard, but I like to try new things. And what I'm doing on top to give it a little bit more color is I'm just going to use the blackening, which is going to make it a bit more of a reddish mahogany color. Once you've seasoned the brisket to your preference, just let it rest for 10-15 minutes, and then you're ready to throw it on the smoker. Today I'm going to be using my pellet smoker. I know that you're not going to get as much bark or anything like that, but I am busy today and I want a nice, tasty Sunday roast dinner.
All right, so our corned brisket has been smoking away now for about 90 minutes. Let's go and have a little look and see how it's going. The corned brisket has been smoking away now for approximately 2.5 hours. I haven't sprayed it with any water yet. Let's go and have a look, see how the bark is forming. I might give it a little spray now just to keep a little bit of moisture in there, but so far it's smelling good and looking good. So my corned brisket has been smoking away now for approximately just over 5 hours. I don't think I'm going to be in the store yet. I don't think it's going to be quite there, but I've got to go out this afternoon, which is why I'm cooking on my pellet smoker today. So let's take a look. Let's wrap it up in the beef stock and the onion that I want to wrap it up in, and we'll just see how this thing turns out.
I didn't record the temperature check, but it was about 152 degrees Fahrenheit. So not quite in the stall, but pellet smokers, love them or hate them, they are still great to use. You can set your temperature, you can forget, you can go and do the things that you need to do outside of your home, and you're still gonna enjoy a nice meal. So what I'm doing here is I'm just putting in some beef stock, a little bit more seasoning, as well as some onions. And I'm gonna wrap it up and throw it back into the smoker. Thank you. brisket was probing beautifully. It was super soft. It's probably gone a little bit over what I wanted. I was aiming for about 204, 205. It was probing about that 208 to 209. So I was hoping this brisket wouldn't crumble. I've given it here a 2.5 hour rest. Yep, 2.5 hours, and it is still piping hot. And what I was really happy about, despite going that little bit extra to 208, it did not crumble at all. And as you can see, you've got a beautiful smoke color, you've got a beautiful corned beef color, and I was super happy with the results. It was juicy, it may not have had the greatest bark in the world, but I achieved exactly what I wanted out of this cook. Let's do the important thing now, which is cut it up and give it the all-important taste test. The tenderness was on point, absolutely outstanding. What would I change next time? I would probably leave it in water for around 4 to 5 hours. It was still a little bit salty, but with my Sunday roast dinner, I made some cauliflower with some cauliflower cheese sauce, and that white sauce really toned it down, and it made it a beautiful meal. Thanks for watching, guys. See you again in the next one.